The biggest difference between the laundering process at home versus a dry cleaning facility is the use of electric heat.
Why can't I get my clothes to turn out the same way at home as when I have a dry cleaner do my laundry? At home, we either hang wet clothes out on the line, does anyone still do this? Or we throw them in the dryer. At a dry cleaner, we have the benefit of using steam irons and presses as opposed to electrically heated equipment. Steam heated irons and presses that allow controlled bursts of steam do a much better job of finishing the garments in the hands of an experienced presser. Steam, as opposed to an electric iron or an electric dryer, in no way scorches, burns, or shrinks fabric. Clothes are taken straight from the washer and put on the presses. That's why shrinkage isn't really an issue with the dry cleaner, since it's electrically generated heat that shrinks clothing fibers. Want to guess what the second largest contributor to shrinkage is? Holidays. How do I get charged more for my little blouse than a big men's shirt? There's like half the material there. Ruffles, silk, dainty buttons, intricate detailing, all of the things that make a lovely and delicate blouse also makes it just that, delicate. Some women's blouses will not fit on our machines, or the pressure of the press would be too much for their decorative buttons or ruffles or tapering. Where a sturdy men's shirt can be put on the presses, delicate items have to be processed separately by hand. Since you're already on your computer, go to your search engine and search for the phrase invisible stain. After you finish watching this video, of course. We promise we are not making this up. Think of when you've taken a bite out of an apple. The meat of the apple is fresh and white after the bite, but the longer it's exposed, the browner the meat of the apple will turn. This is the same principle behind the invisible stain. When some clear liquid like white wine or food juices spill on a shirt, it may not leave a visible stain, but the sugars in the liquid begin oxidizing in the fibers of the garment. So when we expose the shirt to heat during the pressing process, it turns those oxidized fibers brown. The longer the stain went before being treated, the darker the stain will be. So how do you beat the culprit before it ruins your shirt?
Excuse me. Could I have some club soda, please?
Treat the stain immediately, and then get the garment to a dry cleaner as soon as possible, before the stain starts oxidizing too much. There is a bleach spot on my garment. Is it possible it was bleached at the dry cleaner? Bleach is a dirty word for dry cleaners, and we don't keep any bleaching agents on the premises, chlorine or otherwise. What's more likely is that you're coming into contact with bleaching agents that you aren't even aware of. There are tons of products that could damage your clothes, including colognes, aftershaves, deodorants, toothpaste, facial cleansers, and many others. Also, beware of sitting down at a restaurant immediately after the table has been bussed. Generally, bussers will use a towel soaked in bleach water to sanitize the table, which will damage clothes. Just give the table a moment to dry. There is a rule of thumb that we, as well as all other dry cleaning operations, follow, and that is that the stain is yours, the color is ours. That simply means that we will try our best to remove any and all stains, but we will stop attempts if, by removing the stain, we have to damage the integrity or the color of the fabric. We didn't get the red wine or the ink on the garment, but if we have to further damage the garment to remove the stain, well, that would be our responsibility.
How do they keep everything straight?
When you bring in your clothes, we enter a brief description of the items you bring and assign a number to each item. Those numbers are recorded on your receipt, along with the drop-off time, date, and a barcode. Once the clothes are washed, pressed, and hung, they are grouped together again according to their numbers and packaged for pickup. That's why it's so important that you hold on to your receipt. 99% of our orders come back accurate, so it's a non-issue. But for that occasional mix-up, it will make it so much easier to look at the numbers and date on your receipt and find the missing item. Providing an itemized receipt is more time-consuming for the customer, and people are usually in a hurry. If you do need an itemized receipt, skip the drive-thru and come on inside. Why is there not more attention to detail for buttons? Buttons do take a beating during the pressing process. Our presses that get your shirt so pristinely stiff employ enough pressure to crush a human hand. And after being heated to roughly 270 degrees, some might actually crack while cooling down. We keep an eye out for any broken or missing buttons, but we admit that we will miss some. If, when you check your order, you notice a broken button, we can quickly sew on a new one at no extra charge. It's 9:05. You seriously won't be able to have this by 5 o'clock? I'm only 5 minutes past the cutoff time. We are, admittedly, pretty strict about our 9 a.m. cutoff for a 5 p.m. pickup. This allows us time to process, clean, and assemble the many hundreds of garments we take in a day. Whew, makes me tired just talking about it. So you can see, there is a lot to get through in only 8 hours, so we have to run a pretty tight ship. Not to toot our own horn or anything, but WCK Cleaners is proud of the fact that we have never used the industry staple, perchloroethylene, on our premises. We use EcoSolve, which is environmentally friendly, and we use the best equipment so that we can reclaim and reuse 98% of our EcoSolve solvent. Here's the lowdown on dry cleaning pricing for your typical collared button front shirt. Most cleaners price their shirts at just above the break-even point with just a little profit. Not much, but a little. In our market, that's between $2.19 and $2.29 a shirt. Most operations that still offer 99 cents or $1.09 per shirt are losing money in that category, but are using the low shirt cost to entice folks to bring in higher ticket items in order to make up for that loss. Now you know. We, along with all other dry cleaners or businesses that routinely offer coupons, must be presented with incoming order on the coupons. Accepting coupons at a later time and adjusting orders that are already processed with a specific dollar value applied skews accurate accounting and record keeping. Caution. Once orders leave the store, not only is it more difficult to rectify any discrepancies on the spot, it's more difficult to determine if there was a discrepancy to begin with. That's why all missing item claims must be made before you leave with your order. Most issues are resolved by finding a missing or lost item in a spouse's closet, put there by accident, or hidden next to a larger item that one didn't see in a darkened closet.
That's just one more piece of dry cleaning wisdom brought to you by WCK Cleaners.